Welcome to the first episode of Kitchen Matters, a series put together by graduate students at the MIT Material Science and Engineering Department on material science and food. Our team has a problem to solve. We'd like to make a good batch of brownies, but we all have different ideas on what makes the brownie good. Luckily, we're all material scientists, so we can put our engineering skills to use and create an optimal brownie. But first, what is material science? Ethan, can you explain it to our viewers?
Sure, Jackie. Put simply, material science is the study of the relationship between a material structure, or how the atoms are arranged, and its properties, or how it behaves. And by materials, we really mean everything you can see around you, from building materials like steel and concrete to electronic materials like silicon. However, the story actually goes much deeper than that. The link between structure and properties is a very important part of material science, but it won't tell us how to actually design materials to certain specifications. To do this, we need to introduce the material science tetrahedron. The tetrahedron shows that even though structure and properties are important, they're not independent. They depend on other concepts, processing and performance. Processing refers to how we can change a material by subjecting it to various treatments, such as heating, cooling, and rolling. These treatments change a material structure, and thus its properties. Performance refers to how well a material is suited for the role we want it to play. This is affected by its properties. So we can see that the material science tetrahedron encapsulates all of these major concepts of material science. So, what does any of this have to do with brownies? As it turns out, a lot. After all, brownies are made of atoms. They have properties which we can affect by how we process or bake them. And we want them to perform well, for instance, by meeting all of our team's demands. Jackie, can you use the material science tetrahedron to make the optimal brownies?
Sure. Let's start with performance. Like we said, each of our team members has a different idea on what makes a brownie good, so we need to take all of their suggestions into account. Now, what properties should we use to make a satisfying batch of brownies? For Ming, it has to be really chocolatey. For Camille, it has to be really cakey. And for Robin, it has to have crispy corners. These will help us make decisions on structure and processing. Structure is where we'll decide the shape, form, and ingredients of our brownies. Are we going for a plain brownie, or will we add anything extra? Is there anything else we'd like to add? Ming likes chocolatey brownies, which could mean that we want to go more towards the fudgy side. This generally means adding more butter and chocolate and less flour. But on the other hand, Camille wants a more cakey texture. This means more flour and less butter and chocolate. We could even add baking powder to act as a leavening agent. So, how can we strike a compromise? Well, we found a recipe optimized to satisfy both Ming and Camille. It uses a high chocolate to flour ratio to make it fudgy and baking powder to make it cakey. Processing is where we'll actually make it. This is pretty much the directions you'd see at the back of a brownie box. How high to set the oven and how long to bake it. Do we want to use a round pan or a square one? If we want to have crispy corners, we can't use a round pan. There aren't any edges. Now, all that's left is to put them in and wait till they're done. The fruits of our labor. Did we meet all of our constraints and satisfy our team members? To find out, we'd have to characterize these brownies. Characterization, this symbol in the sensor of the material science tetrahedron, refers to the tests we use to probe a material in order to learn more about a structure and properties, and it tells us what processing steps we need to apply to improve that material's performance. In this case, characterization is the best part because it means eating the brownies. The brownie has crispy corners, so Robin should be happy with it. But it's probably not as fudgy as Ming would like, or as cakey as Camille would like. Often in engineering, that's just what happens. There's no perfect brownie that'll make everyone happy, so the best we could do is make one within a range of tolerances. But man, that was easy. I should go pick up my PhD tomorrow.
Whoa, hold on a second. Brownies are easy, but what about this? A crispy chocolate liege waffle covered in vanilla ice cream, fruit sphere gummies, and homemade maple syrup. We still have a lot to learn before we can understand this complicated dessert. Over the course of this series, we'll be teaching you how to apply material science concepts to everyday foods using the framework of the material science tetrahedron. At the end of the series, you'll not only be able to recreate this beautiful dessert, You'll also be able to apply these concepts to your own creations.